Hello everyone and welcome to another video. Today I have a tiny action camera that's advertised as 4K. It's from a brand called LeadEdge and it currently sells for $89.99 Canadian dollars. Before we have a look at it, please consider subscribing to my channel so I can make more videos. Let's look at its specs first. It can shoot at 4K at 30 frames per second, 1080p at 60 frames per second, and 720p at 120 FPS. It also has electronic image stabilization and Wi-Fi. It comes with a lot of accessories such as a case, an extra battery, an external microphone, a remote, and an extension stick. I wish it came with a larger case so that I would be able to store the accessories in it as well. For now, I have to store the accessories in the cardboard box that the camera came in. The build quality is pretty good. I like the soft plastic they used, and the battery cover is easy to open. It supports microSD cards up to 32 GB, but it doesn't come with one. It does not have a touch screen. When you turn it on, you realize that the integrated screen has a horrible image quality. Not only is it very low resolution, but the viewing angles are also not good. The interface at first seems quite easy to navigate, but as you use it, you realize that it's not quite intuitive. You use the menu button to change the shooting mode, to go to playback menu, and to go to settings. If you accidentally click the menu button once, it takes 7 clicks to the menu button and 1 click to the shutter button to go back. Firstly, when you go to settings, the menu page count just doesn't work. Moreover, you need to click the shutter button at the end of settings to get out of it. Anyways, you'll eventually get used to it. It's actually the same interface as my SeekBeak camera. I've made a video about it last summer, but a quick warning, it was the very first YouTube video I made, so the quality is just not good. The fact that I used the action camera to film didn't help either. Shortly after you start using this camera, you will realize that it's not made for taking breathtaking 4K videos. In any case, it's an $80 camera. It has a wide-angle fisheye lens, and you're not able to turn that off in the settings. You might be able to do it using Premiere Pro or After Effects. The video quality is alright for the price. It has a wide-angle lens, so the field of vision is pretty good. However, you might have realized by now that it's not actually 4K. This camera feels a lot like a car dashcam. It also comes with a car mount, and it actually has a dashcam mode. This footage is taken at 4K at 30 FPS. This footage is taken at 1080p at 60 FPS. And this footage is taken at 720p at 120 FPS. As you can see, there is not much difference when I change the resolution. I said that it has Wi-Fi, so let's try that out. It doesn't connect your home Wi-Fi network, instead it creates its own. You need to download an app called LiveDV on your phone, and once you connect to the network, you'll be able to control the camera. You can actually change a lot of settings, and you even get extra features like filters. I've talked about these filters in my SeekBeak video, they're pretty useless. At night, it's not horrible either. There's a lot of noise, and the camera often loses focus, but the footage actually doesn't look that bad. As you can see, the electronic image stabilization doesn't work that well either. It has an integrated microphone and the sound quality is okay. It also comes with an external microphone, however, it's a horrible one and no matter what you do, there is always background static. I've had a problem with my old SeekBeak camera where the video would get distorted every now and then. Fortunately, I haven't had that problem with this one. Battery life is decent. As I said before, it comes with two batteries and each battery will last 70 minutes when recording in 4K. It also works when it's plugged in. I use this camera to record my mattress expanding, and I quickly realized that the estimated recording time is very inaccurate. Overall, this isn't a great camera. However, if you're looking for a cheap action camera, this is a good one that comes with a lot of accessories. Cyclists, for example, can use this camera as a dash cam. It comes with a lot of underwater accessories, but I haven't tried if they actually make it waterproof. Thank you so much for watching. Please consider liking this video, checking out my other videos, and subscribing to my channel. I hope I'll see you all next time. Take care.